topic of this chapter is stereotypes. These are the preconceived ideas about anything. This happens when we take things for granted without any in-depth knowledge. If we generalize all people of a particular group into one image, we create a stereotype. Here are some statements that we frequently hear in our day-to-day life. Every time you must be hearing that we always say that girls cry easily. Fair-skinned girls are more beautiful than the dark ones. Villagers are very simple and city folks are cunning. People who speak in English are superior and so on. Thus, stereotype can have a damaging impact as they do not allow us to justice with an individual because we ignore their skills and unique qualities. So after stereotype, the next topic of this chapter is discrimination and inequality. If prejudice is a thought, what is discrimination then? Discrimination is the action towards that thought. Discrimination means to differentiate people on the basis of their class, race, gender, religion, economic background, etc. In spite of an individual's skill and qualification, it leads to ethnic hostilities and disrupts peace of society. Racial arrogance, which means the superior feeling of one race over other, is generated. It leads to suspicion, distrust among the communities, and bitterness prevails and unity of the country is disrupted. Now, I want to give you some examples of discrimination. In India, one of the reasons of discrimination and inequality is caste system. In the past, many social evils cracked in the Indian society. One of these evils is caste system that is still prevalent and causing a great damage to the society as a whole. The origin of the caste system in India can be traced back to the ancient times in later Vedic age, whereby society was divided into four varnas or occupational groups. This was based on the division of labor and power in society. With the passage of time, the caste system became rigid and hereditary and evil also. If overlooked, a person's potential and enterprise and denied opportunities to competent men, the caste system creates a divide within society and weakens nation as a whole. Great reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Swami Vivekanand, Mahatma Gandhi, etc., they all worked tirelessly to provide dignity to the untouchables in the caste-ridden Indian society. The constitution refers to them as scheduled caste, though they call themselves as Dalits. Now, the second example of this inequality is untouchability. Untouchables were the worst sufferers before the implementation of the Constitution of India. As I have already told you, so tell me, who are untouchables? Can you tell me who are untouchables? Yes, people born in the low caste families were considered as untouchables and suffered injustice. After independence, the government was committed to the upliftment of the untouchables as was desired by our foundation fathers. So, children, today in this much only. Thank you.